This is BBC Radio 3. Now, Choral Evensong, which was first broadcast live from the Chapel of King's College, Cambridge, on Wednesday. The service features the music of Felix Mendelssohn in the 200th anniversary year of his birth. The canticles are the Magnificat and Nunc Dimittis, which Mendelssohn originally conceived for use in Anglican services, but which were later published as German motets. And the anthem is Hör mein Bitten, Hear My Prayer, which was composed during Mendelssohn's eighth visit to England between May and July 1844, and also later published in German. The words are based on Psalm 55. The service opens now with an introit which wasn't published until 1848, a year after Mendelssohn's death. Herr, gedenke nicht, Lord, remember not our wrongdoings, and have mercy on us in our misery.
Beloved, we are come together in the presence of Almighty God and of the whole company of heaven to offer unto him through our Lord Jesus Christ our worship and praise and thanksgiving, to make confession of our sins, to pray as well for others as for ourselves. Wherefore, let us remember God's presence with us now.
O Lord, open thou our lips, and our mouths shall show forth thy praise.
O God, make speed to save us.
O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the
The choir sings the Psalms 59, 60, and 61.
Save me from the blood of us.
Here beginneth the 18th verse of the 44th chapter of the book of Genesis. Then Judah came near unto Joseph and said, O my lord, let thy servant, I pray thee, speak a word in my lord's ear, and let not thine anger burn against thy servant, for thou art even as Pharaoh. My lord answered his servants, saying, Have ye a father or a brother? And we said unto my lord, We have a father, an old man, and a child of his old age, a little one. And his brother is dead, and he alone is left of his mother, and his father loveth him. And thou saidst unto thy servants, Bring him down unto me, that I may set mine eyes upon him. And we said unto my lord, The lad cannot leave his father, for if he should leave his father would die. And thou saidst unto thy servants, Except your youngest brother come down with you, ye shall see my face no more. And it came to pass, when we came up to thy servant my father, we told him the words of my lord. And our father said, Go again, and buy us a little food. And we said, We cannot go down. If our youngest brother be with us, then will we go down. For we may not see the man's face, except our youngest brother be with us. And thy servant my father said unto us, Ye know that my wife bare me two sons, and the one went out from me. And I said, Surely he is torn in pieces, and I saw him not since. And if ye take this also from me, and mischief befall him, ye shall bring down my gray hairs with sorrow to the grave. Now therefore, when I come to thy servant my father, and the lad be not with us, seeing that his life is bound up in the lad's life, it shall come to pass, when he seeth that the lad is not with us, that he will die, and thy servants shall bring down the gray hairs of thy servant our father with sorrow to the grave. For thy servant became surety for the lad unto my father, saying, If I bring him not unto thee, then I shall bear the blame to my father for ever. Now therefore, I pray thee, let thy servant abide, instead of the lad, a bondman to my lord, and let the lad go up with his brethren. For how shall I go up to my father, and the lad be not with me? Lest peradventure I see the evil that shall come on my father. Here endeth the first lesson.
Thank you. Here beginneth the 10th verse of the 2nd chapter of the Epistle to the Hebrews. For it became Jesus, for whom are all things, and by whom are all things, in bringing many sons unto glory, to make the captain of their salvation perfect through sufferings. For both he that sanctifieth and they who are sanctified are all of one, for which cause he is not ashamed to call them brethren, saying, I will declare thy name unto my brethren. In the midst of the church will I sing praise unto thee. And again, I will put my trust in him. And again, behold, I and the children which God hath given me. For as much then as the children are partakers of flesh and blood, he also himself likewise took part of the same, that through death he might destroy him that had the power of death, that is, the devil, and deliver them who through fear of death were all their lifetime subject to bondage. For verily he took not on him the nature of angels, but he took on him the seed of Abraham. Wherefore in all things it behoved him to be made like unto his brethren, that he might be a merciful and faithful high priest in things pertaining to God, to make reconciliation for the sins of the people. For in that he himself hath suffered being tempted, he is able to succor them that are tempted. Here endeth the second lesson.
Thank you.
I believe in God.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of sins, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Almighty God, who seest that we have no power of ourselves to help ourselves, keep us both outwardly in our bodies and inwardly in our souls, that we may be defended from all adversities which may happen to the body, and from all evil thoughts which may assault and hurt the soul. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Almighty and everlasting God, who hatest nothing that thou hast made, and dost forgive the sins of all them that are penitent, create and make in us new and contrite hearts, that we, worthily lamenting our sins and acknowledging our wretchedness, may obtain of thee, the God of all mercy, perfect remission and forgiveness, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
O God, from whom all holy desires, all good counsels, and all just works do proceed, give unto thy servants that peace which the world cannot give, that both our hearts may be set to obey thy commandments, and also that by thee, we being defended from the fear of our enemies, may pass our time in rest and quietness. Through the merits of Jesus Christ, our Savior. We beseech thee, O Lord, and by thy great mercy defend us from all perils and dangers of this night, for the love of thy only Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. This evening's anthem is a setting by Mendelssohn of words taken from Psalm 55. Hear my prayer, O God, incline thine ear, hör mein Bitten.
Thank you.
Let us pray. O God, whose blessed Son didst suffer for all mankind, grant unto us that, rightly observing this holy season, we may learn to know thee better, to love thee more, and to serve thee with a more perfect will. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
God of our fathers, who of old didst move thy servant King Henry VI to build this house of prayer for the offering of eternal praises to thy glorious majesty, grant to us and to all who herein call upon thy holy name from age to age, that by offering of our lives and the praises of our lips, we may ever seek the increase of thy glory and thy kingdom. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Bring us, O Lord God, at our last awakening, into the house and gate of heaven, to enter into that gate and dwell in that house, where there shall be no darkness nor dazzling, but one equal light, no noise nor silence, but one equal music, no fears nor hopes, but one equal possession, no ends nor beginnings, but one equal eternity, in the habitations of thy glory and dominion, world without end.
Amen.
Christ crucified, draw you to himself, to find in him a sure ground for faith, a firm support for hope, and the assurance of sins forgiven. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be amongst you and remain with you always.
Amen.
We sing the hymn, Take Up Thy Cross.
Thank you.
The fugue from Mendelssohn's Organ Sonata No. 6 in D minor, Opus 65. And it brings Choral Evensong to a close. The service was recorded last Wednesday in the chapel of King's College, Cambridge. The director of music was Stephen Clebury, and the organ scholar was Peter Stevens. The treble soloist was Sebastian Johns.